ng inyong office para sa mga sa army personnel po. At saka sige, bago kay Sir Colonel Losero pa ibalik ko muna kay Samira ikasya ang pasin kay Samira yung naman na microphone na please welcome.
Ipikikilalakan pa sinagi yung pag-react na sundero because sometimes ka misinterpret yung damadakla to na yung role ng mga sundero. The role of soldiers is to, as constitutional role yan, o pa man nagia COMELEC, Commission on Elections, being a constitutional body, nagia security force tanong, gia puwersa a sundero, Armed Forces of the Philippines, nasiran in non-partisan neutral body, na may letanod pa man the effectivity of gia role iran between RIDO and feuding families. So gia pa man na pag-react na sundero, Brigade Commander Daniel Lucero, na pirad ni mga kurso niya on securities. He is even lecturing sa Foreign Service Institute, the Department of Foreign Affairs. He is also holding masteral degrees, several masteral degrees. Agugiya pa man management yan ni Mantona, not just Lanao del Sur, but Lanao del Norte. Now pa man agyad ni panawagan na kan those politicians, yung mga pagarito, saktanod mga political leaders, na in support of this constitutional practice of elections and clean registration. Na ditanod pa man agyong mga sundero na wag nating pasukan ng whatever pa man ang mga kuan political agenda siran because they are not supposed to be influenced in any way. So this is to give pa man panawagan sa mga civilians o pa man and politicians that please wag niyo pinapahirapan po yung mga sundalo here and there giya pa man na security forces by sending them whatever, sending them your people, sending them requests. They are even not as even allowed to make decisions on certain electoral issues. So giya pa man COMELEC has to make that decision. And so giya pa man pagariya ka na Daniel Lucero, a now 10 outstanding soldier of the Philippines by the Metrobank Foundation, give him the support to manage this 7 days more to have a clean registration, which is the start of a clean election. So Colonel Dan.
Sige po, salamat. Sam, assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Thanks kilakilat si Abol and si Musa. Good morning ho sa inyong lahat. I just want to give you some updates on what happened, what transpired after 3 days of general registration. First, generally peaceful ang Lanao del Sur, say compared to the 2010 election. What are the recent incidents? First, marami ang mga flying registrants. I mean, nung na-checkpoint sila sa Sagiran and Malabang, I requested and I required all battalion commanders to give lectures to those whom we suspect as flying registrants. You know, I just want to relate to everyone that according to in relation to the Omnibus Election Code, anybody, kung sino man mahuhuli na mag-entry sa kanyang registration ng fraudulent or hindi totoo o salimbot, he can be penalized 1 to 6 years perpetual prohibition to hold any public office kahit konsehal lang ng barangay. What does this mean? Pag naging guilty kayo dito, you cannot get an MBA clearance, which means now once you can't get an MBA clearance, you cannot get a passport. Pag hindi ka nakakuha ng passport, hindi ka makapag-abroad. Or sa ating mga kababayan, hindi ka makapag-hajj. Sa mga professionals, hindi kayo makakuha ng PRC, a license. After hearing yung lectures ng ating mga battalion commanders, marami ang bumalik. As far mga galing ng Bukidnon, galing ng Usamis, galing ng Iligan, galing ng Jensan, galing ng Dipolog. So I think we have made our message that we will not tolerate itong mga flying registrants. Second, I was in Butik the other day and merong commotion doon. I was able to talk to the warring families, the warring political groups under former Mayor Pansar at Mayor Makadato kahapon. Nandun sila sa brigade and because of this commotion, because of this illegal discharge ng firearms, nag-back out yung EO, yung election officers galing sa Manila. And because of that, I requested Mayor Makadato to call in his members of this council, at kahapon nga nag-usap kami sa brigade, and they assured us in front of Commissioner Velasco that they will support, they will secure, and we will see to it na yung mga constituents niya will support the ongoing registration. Walang salimbot, walang nanakot dito, and actually the group is now on its way to Butik to resume yung registration. Third is, there's a an incident that we discovered yesterday in at MSU. Though we will be filing charges against this individual, he coerced about 30 students to register under a different name. About 30 students, mga tiga Butuan to, you know, mga first year tiga Agusan, who were coerced to register under a different name. And I've been, you know, coordinating with the administration of MSU, and I have also asked the legal comment of Commissioner Velasco, and sure enough, you know, we will file appropriate charges to that individual, and I hope that this will be the last time, you know, that we will hear this kind of salimbot. You know, this is actually an insult, you know, to our youth. Sisirain natin yung mga estudyante. Gaya rin itong mga estudyante, if ever they will be found out to be guilty of faults, crimes, then kawawa itong mga estudyante. And even though they graduate, they cannot get any license because of these crimes that if ever they will be found to have committed. Another thing that I want to highlight is some measures that we have adopted to prevent the escalation of RIDO, particularly sa Masyo. Sa Masyo, I personally went there and naayos natin yung RIDO dyan between the Pangandaman and the Giling. And in fact, ini-escorta namin yung mga families ni Giling so that, you know, hindi mag-ignite ng conflict between the other side. To include yung problema natin sa Pikong between the Saliling family and the Balindongs. And ngayon, we're hoping our schemes will be effective. However, lately, this morning at around 6:30, there was a shooting incident. One individual was killed by the name of Saud in Dumba, Kaunayan, 6:30. And we think that this is not related registration, hindi pa naman sisimula. So, and also, mayroon tension dyan between the present mayor and his relatives. So far, we have also averted any conflict sa Tugaya. Maganda sa Tugaya, we were there 1 month before the registration, and we were able to talk to the warring families. Alam natin si Alim, and we were there actually yesterday with Commissioner Velasco. In place yung aming mga security arrangement. Sa Kapay, ganun din. Na-avert natin yung mga conflict dyan. And significant enough, yung hindi mapuntahan na registration center sa Taguloan, helicopter ang nag-service. You know, we have requested the availability of a helicopter para sa upper Taguloan. So, chopper ang nag-service na ngayon. Yes. And in fact, nakadalawang biyahe na because nasira yung VRM, yung voter registration machine. So, as of the moment, we can say that yung registration natin peaceful. However, hindi natin maiwasan. Indeed, I am not an expert on determining the age of registrants, but obviously, you know, basing from my intuition, you know, maraming underage. Yes, but I'd like to inform everyone, hindi ako taga Comelec, but because of the so many briefings that I got from Comelec, itong ating registration ngayon is just an application.
Arriving in Marami, Washington Post, of Commander A little overwhelming, you know. We didn't expect that this activity will be attended by this great number of those who want to share our dreams for reform. Kasalimbago. I was just actually to give you a background on how come this activity was pursued. In fact, I'd like to underscore the openness and the frankness of all those who love to change for the better. We started actually immediately after the filing of the certificate of candidacy in October of last year, when I met members of the 28 radio forums in Lanadosur. 28. This meeting was attended by almost around 150 members of the different radio forums in Lanadosur, and they were kind enough to share with us what happened during the last election. One of the things that they shared here was the lack of cooperation, the lack of trust, and the mostly the army, the PNP, the government, and the teachers, and the CSO. And they recommended that we should solve this. We should high time, that we should meet and cooperate. We are believing, and I believe, that this election is ours. Anybody who fails to do his job properly will definitely affect the whole election. And I think the reason why, one of the reasons why you came here is because you want to give your share for reform for Kasimbago. Who among you residents of Lanadosur would like your leaders, your political officers, to be chosen from voters from Maguindanao? Who among you mayors of Lanadosur would like to be chosen by people from Iligan? Meron ba? And I think this is the reason why we are here. We are here because we want to protect the gains that we have achieved during the last general registration. Again, I'd like to underscore and thank the Provincial Election Supervisor and to all Philippine National Police members who join us in pursuing an honest to goodness registration. We have deleted 171,000, shall I say, most voters from our list. And I believe we cannot afford to lose the momentum. Being your security officer and one of the security officers, I believe that chaos and violence are pursued because people fail to get justice. However, if we can do this, and if we can assure everyone that we will not cheat, then I don't think everybody can reduce violence. This is what we call in the military parlance, left of the bomb. Before any bomb explodes, let's prevent this bomb from exploding. And we can only do this by discussing among ourselves what should be the best way to prevent this bomb from exploding. The people of Lanadosur have sent a strong message that we want reform. However, don't expect that we can achieve a new result in this election if we will still continue the same culture. Don't expect that new results will be achieved if we will still use the same formula. Only good to that. So if we want to gain an acceptable result, it should be a reflection of the people's will. We have to approach this, challenge by getting rid of the malpractices that allegedly were done during the past political election. I believe Royal Corporation, with your enthusiasm, with your belief that the finger of one is the finger of all, we can do this. The most important thing that we should take into consideration is accountability. Every member of the armed forces, every member of the Philippine National Police, every member of the VTEC, the CSOs, the government, should be accountable to anything that happens here. Because pag hindi natin nakuha yung sense of responsibility sa atin, and we fail to get what we want, that will start the day beginning. So I'd like to enjoin everyone, let's take this political exercise as ours. Let's do our share. Let's see to it that anything that we do will be in pursuit of that what we call hope.
I would like to thank the ating principal actors. Kung wala sila, I don't think this activity will be successful. I'd like to specially mention yung ating incumbent mayor, si Mayor Fahad Pren. Palakpakan natin siya! Si Sultan Ahmad Maroon. Sultan Duma at si Madam Rasmin Garandada. Maraming salamat. Andito rin sa ating kandidato from Tagapo, si Madam Makatanong at si Alice Madam. Minsan ko na yung presidente, wala pa nangyari ito. And I'd like to thank and underscore yung suporta na binigay sa amin ng MILF. Nandiyan si Brother Osama Ali at si Brother James Pakaraya, palakpakan natin siya. I'd also like to thank yung ating team site leader ng International Monitoring Team na nakabase sa Iligan, si Captain Muhammad Isudin. Walang pa nangyari ito na nandito yung apat na kandidato ang magkakatabi. Ihingi natin sa kanila ang assurance na magkakaroon tayo ng eleksyon dito sa Marawi at sa Jampigapo at sa Kampay na may pagmamalaki ng lahat ng taga Marawi. Kami ay kasama nyo para magmalaki sa buong Pilipinas na kaya natin dito sa Marawi ang malinis at mapayapang eleksyon. Kaya ba natin ito? I have lost a number of soldiers. Tatlong namatay ng sundalo, upo ang nasugatan. And they died and they lost their limbs. Naputulan ang paa. To provide every resident ng Marawi City na magandang environment na lahat kayo ay makakapag-practice ng inyong karapatan. And we have shouted to the world, to the nation, that we can do it. Kasama ko dito yung mga cause-oriented groups, yung mga CSOs, yung mga 28 members ng Radio Forum. Madami po sila, at dito po sila lahat na tumutulong sa atin para spread yung news na kaya natin dito sa Marawi, kaya natin dito sa Lahat ng Sur. The people have spoken. Na-recognize po tayo ng COMELEC comparing Lahat ng Sur with other four municipal, four provinces dito sa ARM, we have deleted 172,000 ghost voters. And dito sa Marawi, we have deleted almost 50%. That's more than 33,000. And we have made a giant step para may pakita natin At ngayong eleksyon, may mapakita din natin sa buong mundo na kaya natin ito. Gusto kong i-request sa ating mga apat na kandidato, we have requested them to give a few words, 2 minutes each, to give an assurance to everyone that they will strictly adhere doon sa ating signan, isa-signan na kapasalan. This agreement is not only an agreement between human beings. This will be done na magsiswear tayo sa Quran. This is actually a covenant between us and Allah. And I don't think, you know, we will fail the people. Sana sa nadating na eleksyon, malinis ang magiging halalan. And I assure everyone, like everyone to hear this, that I will not allow any of my soldiers to be involved in any election irregularities. Meron kayong narinig na irregularities, pati yung irregularity ni General Zero, i-report nyo. I will not push my soldiers to harm's way just to guard cheatings. Hindi ko po pwede pwede makonsensya na dadare ko yung sundalo ko ng gwardyahan yung pandarayan. Again, isa sa mga challenge at isa sa mga approaches natin sa gawa kung bakit naging mapayapa ang legislation natin, yung last July registration was the installation of CCTVs, yung closed-circuit TV cameras. I'd like to publicly ask and request yung ating apat na kandidato, if they can loan to us, sa akin at sa polis, kung pwedeng mapahiram mo po kami ng maybe tiga-lima o tiga-apat na CCTV, ikakabit natin sa mga polling places at ibabalik namin after the election. I'd like to get their answers once we request them to say a few words. Itong CCTV natin, ikakabit natin sa polling places. Pagkatapos ng election, ibabalik namin sa kanila. Pakay ba kayo? Hindi ako kandidato. Sa more than 2 years ko dito, I've learned to love Marawi. I've learned to love the people. And I assure you, nakasama nyo kami para maging malinis at may pagmamalaki natin ang eleksyon din sa Marawi, sa Pekapo at sa ang buong Lanao del Sur sa darating na eleksyon. Again, sa ating ang apat na kandidato, ang lahat ng tao ay may karapatang pumili ng kanyang leader na walang pananakot. Ako po ay siyang taga Puerto Princesa, Palawan, at hindi po ako papayag na yung aking gobernador sa Palawan ay pipiliin ng taga Mindoro. Hindi ako papayag na aming mayor sa Puerto Princesa ay pipiliin ng taga Manila. I think ganito rin kayo. I think and I heard the people of Marawi that they will not allow people from outside to choose their mayor. Alam ko, hindi kayo papayag na yung mayor nyo ay pipiliin ng taga Manila. Papayag ba kayo? So again, the people have spoken. Makakasa po kayo. Meron po kayong reklamo, i-text po sa aming hotline sa brigade. At makakasa po kayo. Handa po yung inyong kapulisan, yung inyong kasundaluan, na ipagmalaki natin ang darating na eleksyon.
dito sa Marawi at ang buong Lagang Luzon. Maraming pong salamat sa mga like ko.